Praise the Lord. Time to get started tonight. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, sir.
I forgot what I was going to say.
Anyways, it's good to see everyone in the house of the Lord tonight. And we pray that you've had a blessed and wonderful week so far. Let's stand, let's go before the Lord in prayer tonight, and just let's ask the Lord's blessings on the night. I don't know about you, it's been a busy week, and I'm really tired tonight, so let's pray. Let's ask God for his blessings tonight.
Yes, Jesus.
Father God, we just thank you. We bless you. We honor you, Jesus. Lord, we glorify you, Father God. And Lord, we just bless your holy name, Father, Lord Jesus, that, Lord, you would be glorified, Father. Lord, we ask your touch. We ask your ministry upon every heart and every life tonight, Father God. Strengthen and encourage, Father God, each and every heart and life, Lord God, and just bless, Lord God, Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord God. And we thank you and we honor you and praise you in Jesus' holy name. Amen and amen. Let's worship the Lord.
I hear the sound of your voice.
overwhelmed by you, Jesus. Hallelujah, your presence, oh God. Hallelujah. You know, the good thing about YouTube is I went back today and listened to all those messages God gave us, and I wrote them all down in my journal. Every one of them.
Amen.
So that's what I'm going to start doing. And I'm right back through them, and what an awesome. You know, the Lord said to stand on His word.
Yes, He did.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And to reach out for Him. Hallelujah. That's good.
Still enjoyed. We
of the Lord in us, no matter how our body feels. The flesh is weak, but the spirit is strong. And so, you know, you have to be thankful. And I've been very thankful that I've had friends and people to help me all these few times. And I just want you to know, God is able to do anything and everything in your life.
Amen.
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 All right. Tiara, come and take up the tithes and offering, please. Yes. Are you ready? Father God, we just thank you for the privilege of being able to give unto the house of the Lord. And we thank you that you have kept us and you have blessed us and helped us in all things that we have been in this week. And God, we just thank you. Lord, we see your mighty hand holding on to us and keeping us upright. And we just thank you for that. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Jesus, amen, Benjamin.
Praise the Lord. While she's collecting the offering and tithes for tonight, just a few announcements real quick. Don't forget that on Friday night is Ladies Ministries. Saturday. See, I already got my days mixed up. So Saturday, what time?
6:30.
So ladies, don't forget about that. Also, we have classics Sunday morning after church. And so, and then also, it's going to be a busy weekend. Praise the Lord. We're going to try to pass out some of the food and water on Saturday morning to our community. So we need your help. If you're able and willing, please come join us. We want to do that. One other thing, as many of you know, that Governor Abbott signed these governor's orders to relinquish the mask mandate for the state of Texas. And, you know, I've been thinking a lot about that since it's been happening. And we have always followed everything the state has sent down to us. So with that said, we will not be requiring it here unless you want to. It'll be your personal choice. If you don't feel comfortable, then please, you know, wear it. If you're okay with it, then don't. We're not going to give anybody a hard time about it or anything like that. We will still continue to provide masks and sanitizer, and we'll still continue to sanitize the building as necessary. Just know that we're not going to ask anybody to wear them in if they don't want to. So, but before I get into my message tonight, and this isn't going to be very long. But I've asked Sister Karen. Brother Tom had no idea what I was ministering tonight. He had no idea what I was doing. And I want to ask her to play this video and just worship the Lord tonight. I believe God's just trying to speak to us tonight. Amen.
Amen.
And, you know, God's always trying to speak to you. It's just, you got to listen. Praise the Lord. You got to be open to his voice.
You are my joy. You are my song. You are the well, the one I'm drawing from. You are my refuge, my whole life long. Where else would I go? Surely my God is the strength of defends me. Your love defends me. Then when I feel like I'm all alone, your love defends me. Your love defends me. Surely my God is the strength of my soul. Your love defends me. Your love defends me. Then when I feel like
God is our portion,
yes,
and our
amen.
Salvation.
Amen.
He's the strength to our soul. You know, this song has been in my heart and my spirit since Monday. And I was just curious. I was just like, I wonder what he bases this song off. Because a lot of times artists will base their songs off of certain things. And so I went behind the music. And come to find out that Matt Maher, the writer of this song, he based this song off of Psalms 91. And so tonight, my message is off of Psalms 91.
Man.
If you would turn your Bibles to Psalms 91, we're going to look at the whole chapter, not just part of it, but the whole thing. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Psalms 91, we're just going to begin in verse 1. The word of the Lord says this evening, he who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide the shadow of the Almighty.
Amen.
I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in him I will trust. I want to just stop there just for a few minutes, and I'm going to keep going through this, but we need to know tonight, and I believe this is what the Lord just keeps on speaking, that God is our refuge and our fortress, amen. We can go and run and hide in him in times of need and in times of desperation, hallelujah. You know, I was looking at this, and you know, when it talks about the shadow of the Almighty, we're in the land that where the sun can be oppressive and dangerous, a shadow was understood as a metaphor for care and protection. This is his care and his protection from the blistering, you know, if we will, the oppressiveness and the dangerousness of our day and our time and our hour. God, we can go under his shadow and be protected from those issues. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
And so, you know, this is awesome. But verse 3, he says, surely he will deliver you. When you're abiding in him, when you're dwelling in God,
hallelujah,
he shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler and from perilous pestilence.
Yes, he will.
This represents any plots against the believer intended to endanger your life. Any plot that's, hallelujah, praise the Lord. The every weapon, every plot that the enemy has tried to set against you, he'll bring it to nothing, hallelujah. Because that's who our God is. Praise the Lord. He'll deliver you. If that don't get excited,
amen.
Your excited is broke.
That's right.
Praise the Lord.
I need a new one.
He'll deliver you.
Amen.
From every attempt of the enemy that's trying to destroy you.
Amen.
Hallelujah. He shall cover you. This is actually my scripture right here. With you with his feathers and under his wings you shall take refuge. His truth shall be your shield and your buckler.
Amen.
He'll cover you. This is actually representative of a mama eagle, where mama eagle will protect her younglings from harm and from danger. Hallelujah. So we have hope this evening that God will put his wings over us and protect us from harm and protect us from danger.
Amen.
God is not just a big God, but he is our protector. He's our love. He's our defense.
Yes,
he's our strong tower. He's our hope. He's everything that we need. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's what I love about God, is because God just doesn't stop at salvation.
Yes. Amen.
Right.
You know, if all he did was save us, that would be a miracle.
That's right.
And that'd be awesome. But God goes way beyond that. He sees all the things that we're going through. And he protects us and he keeps us. And he's like, you know, when the devil's at his trying to destroy us, he'll just tell the devil, you back off. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Verse 5, it says, you shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor of the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor of the destruction that lays waste at noonday. These are all examples of what God does for us. 1,000 may fall at your side, and 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come near you.
That's right, amen.
Only with your eyes shall you look. You may see all kinds of craziness going around you, but this says it's not going to come near you.
Amen. Right.
Amen.
It's not going to come near your dwelling. Only with your eyes shall you look and see the reward of the wicked. Because, listen, this sums up the reason why you get all these things. Because you have made the Lord, who is my refuge, even the Most High, your dwelling place.
Praise God.
Because you've made your dwelling place. Because you've decided in your heart and your spirit that there's no other place that you'd rather be than in the presence of the Lord God Almighty. Because you have made that effort, God is saying to you tonight that everything around you will not come near you, and you'll only be able to see it.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Father.
Listen to verse 10. No evil.
That's right. No evil.
Come on.
No evil.
No evil.
No evil.
No evil. None.
No evil. If it looks evil, if it sounds evil, it's evil. But listen to the rest of that scripture. Nor shall any plague come near your dwelling.
Amen.
Nor any plague. Any plague shall come near your dwelling. For he, listen to what God's doing for you. For he shall give his angels charge over you to keep you in all your ways. He's put his angels over you.
Amen.
You know, I remember one thing that we used to always do when we were taking trips anywhere we went, my dad would pull over the car and he would pray over our trip.
Yes, he did.
It didn't matter where we were going. It didn't matter how far the drive. He would always pull over the car, before he put that car in reverse, he would pray over that trip, and he would ask God to put his protective
all around us. Amen. But this is very true. What the Word tells us tonight is that He said He would put His angels charge over you. Hallelujah. His angels are watching over you. They're protecting you, and they're keeping you from all harm. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I'm more excited about this than y'all are. Praise the Lord. Verse 12, in their hands they shall bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. You shall tread upon the lion and the cobra, the young lion and the serpent you shall trample underfoot. Now this does not mean, let me say this, this does not mean to go try trampling on snakes or cobras or anything like that. Don't do anything foolish. Amen. God, you know, even Jesus told Satan, he said, do not tempt the Lord thy God.
That's right.
You know, don't tempt him. You might get bit. You might get eaten. But should you, you know, it's just like the Apostle Paul. As they were sitting around a fire, and a snake jumped out and bit the Apostle Paul. It was a poisonous snake. The Bible records that it was a poisonous, venomous snake.
Right.
But he never got sick and he never got ill. Why is that? Because God was protecting him from all evil and all harm. Hallelujah. Right. So no matter what, God's always, you know, I honestly believe that we will never truly know how much God protects us.
Man.
You don't know. You ever been in your car and God just say, hey, don't go down that street?
Yep, been there.
Or maybe you're having trouble starting your car and you're already late as it is and you're just like, God, I gotta go. Well, that delay is for a reason.
That's right.
True.
Amen. Delays are not always bad. Sometimes delays are just there to protect you from harm and from danger. Hallelujah.
Sure, amen. That's right.
Have a flat tire before you get out of the driveway.
Amen.
It's happened.
Amen. Or all of a sudden you get a phone call that delays you for an hour. Sometimes from a person you don't want to hear from.
Boy, howdy.
Amen. But we know. I mean, we get that. We understand that. Amen. But that's just God's way of keeping us from harm.
That's right.
Now, delay doesn't always mean that your prayers aren't getting answered. Sometimes delays are just there for God to show you a better way. Amen. Verse 14. Listen to what the Lord, this is now, beginning of verse 14, this is God speaking to us. It says, because he has set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. Because you have set your love on God, I will set him on high because he has known my name.
Oh, yes. Thank you, Jesus.
He has set you. He has set his love. When we set our love upon him, he'll deliver us and he'll set us on high. He'll lead us. You know, I love the scripture that says, when my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. Hallelujah. See, when our hopes and all our dreams and everything is shattered, hallelujah, and our heart is overwhelmed, God will pick us up because we have first loved him, and he'll set us upon the rock of our foundation, which is Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen. He He shall, listen to verse 15. He shall call upon me. Hallelujah.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
And I will answer him.
Hallelujah.
You ever just prayed a prayer and then just like, bam, amen, God answered it? Amen. Sometimes you don't even get the prayer out of your mouth and God answers it. Sometimes you just think a thought and God answers it. Amen. I remember, you know, back, I don't know how long it's been, but there was a while I wanted a punching bag, and, you know, because I needed something to take out my frustration on. And I didn't want to take it out on the walls because I didn't want to repair the walls.
Amen.
And so, yeah, sorry, Mark's got a little bit of anger issues. Sorry.
Malachi.
But I didn't even pray about it. It was just something that I had been looking at, something that I'd wanted. I didn't even pray. I didn't even ask for it. And then all of a sudden, me and my wife were getting out of the car. We were going somewhere. And my wife's like, hey, there's a punching bag on the side of the road. And I'm like, what? So I made a circle around the block.
Yep.
No joke. And there that punching bag was, two doors down from my house, that had free on it. See, God knew.
And Mark danced.
Mark danced, hasn't used it in a day since. Hallelujah.
Couldn't hang your clothes on.
Praise the Lord.
Not when it's
but
stuck
God
in the garage.
Will answer when you call upon him.
That's right.
He's never late. He's never busy. But he's always right on time, and he hears your every cry. Hallelujah. He even hears that what your tears are saying to him. You ever been in a place where all you can do is just cry? Can say a word?
Many times. Yes.
Just cry. I mean, sometimes it's all you can do just to release the frustration and release the anger and release everything that's going on in your life. Sometimes that's all you can do. But God even hears the tears in our eyes. Praise the Lord. And I will answer him. Listen to the rest of this verse. I will be with him in trouble. He'll be with you in trouble. You ever been in trouble? Amen. You ever get yourself in trouble?
Amen.
Amen. Come on.
Oh, yeah.
We've all gotten ourselves in trouble. And you know what's awesome about God? Is that when we get ourselves in trouble, he'll save us.
Right.
And he'll rescue us from our own, you know, because of our own fault. Because of something we did. He'll rescue us just because that's who God is.
That's right.
It's the truth.
I will deliver him and honor him. With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation.
Amen.
God is our refuge. He's our strength. He's our defense. He's our strong tower. He's our hope. He's everything that we need when we need it. Hallelujah. Isn't that what Hebrews says? He said, it says that we can boldly come to the throne of grace and mercy that we may find help in the time of need. Hallelujah. So we can find help. My help doesn't come from anything. My help comes from the Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. I'm just going to be flat out honest with you tonight is that these last 2 weeks have been crazy, and if it wasn't for the Lord, I might have pulled out the last bit of hair I have.
Can't even pull it out.
Yeah, Emily, fasten up. I'll do
it. Amen. Because it's just been that crazy. Been that stressful.
Yes, it has.
And the only way, you know, I just get this in your spirit tonight. The only way you can make it through is through Jesus.
Absolutely.
You can't do it on your own.
Absolutely.
I could never do anything on my own. Because we got to understand that without Him, without Jesus,
hallelujah,
we are nothing. God's put you where you're at. Don't you think He knows where you're at?
Yes, He does.
Don't you think? You're like, no, God doesn't see me where I'm at. And that's a lie from the pit of hell.
Yes, it is.
He sees you right where you're at. He sees all the pain. He sees all the frustration. He sees everything you're going through. He sees all the headache. He sees all the hardship. And I'm here to tell you, He's your portion and He's your salvation. And you just trust and believe in Him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He's
Jesus
my portion. He's my salvation.
Thank you, Jesus.
Only through Him and by Him can I even begin to accomplish what He has for me.
Yes, hallelujah.
Only through Him and by Him can you accomplish
That's right.
the things that you're facing and the things you're going through.
Amen.
You'd be like, Brother Mark, you just don't know what I'm going through. Oh, try me. Try me. Try me. You know, I learned it's almost 7 years since being diagnosed from cancer. Time flies. And one thing that God showed me during that time is there's really nothing in this life that's worth getting upset over, getting stressed over, getting upset about. Because when you're faced with death, and you know, people ask me all the time, what's going through cancer? Like, I tell them, it's like facing death face to face.
Yep.
But it's only through the Lord Jesus Christ. Hear this, Pastor, tonight. It's only through Him.
Yes, absolutely.
That I was even able to get through
Amen.
All the stuff that I had to go through.
Amen.
You know, some people say I've got off light. Some people say I got off easy. No, I did not. No, I did not. But I was able to get through because of the Lord Jesus Christ. I said it then, I'll say it now. I don't know how anyone goes through this life without the Lord Jesus. I don't understand. I don't know how. Because if it wasn't for Him, there's no earthly way that I'd be able to go through and walk through the things that I've been through. There's no way for you tonight without Jesus. There's no way.
That's right.
Because it's not by might. It's not by power. But it's by the Spirit, says the Lord.
Amen.
Is He your fortress tonight?
Amen.
Is He your refuge tonight? I just challenge you tonight to put your trust solely on Him, because He's the one that's going to get you through. Maybe you're in the same boat. Maybe you just feel like you're at a point where you're just like ready to toss it all out the door. Cool. I felt that. I felt that in the spirit. Somebody, I don't know if it's here, if it's online, but somebody just... You're at the point where you just feel like you're ready to toss it all out. And God is saying to you tonight, He is your portion.
Amen.
And He is your salvation.
Yes, yes. Amen.
Don't give up. Don't quit. Don't give in. Because that's what the enemy wants you to do. Now's not the time. Like that old song that we used to sing. I've come too far on my journey now. I'm not going to go back. I'm not going to quit. I'm not going to give in. Because I know the Lord is my strength. And the Lord is my shield. And the Lord is my buckler. And the Lord is my hope. And the Lord is my trust. And the Lord is everything that I need Him to be in the moment I need to be. He can be my father. He can be my brother. He can be my sister. He can be whatever I need Him to be when I need Him. And the same goes for you tonight. Whatever you have need of, whatever you're dealing with, whatever you're facing right now, the Lord God Almighty is just saying to you, give it to Him, because He's all that you need in the name of Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Hallelujah. I'm done. Stand.
Hallelujah.
Oh, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. His love defends me.
Yes.
His love defends you tonight.
Amen. Woo! Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He's your fortress.
Your salvation.
He's your salvation.
Yes.
He's your portion.
Yes, He is, God. You are.
He's your strength.
Yes, He is.
Ooh. Receive it in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Receive the strength of the Lord tonight.
Praise the Lord.
Strengthen us, Lord.
Receive it in the name of Jesus.
Receive it in Jesus' name.
Strength, God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Strength.
Receive it in Jesus.
Jesus, right now, Father God.
Receive it in Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus. Jesus. Jesus.
Yes, yes, yes.
Jesus. Come on, can you just say that precious name?
Jesus, hallelujah.
Jesus.
That name that's above every name.
Jesus.
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 Jesus. Jesus. Jesus.
Jesus.
Jesus. Every weapon and every enemy is destroyed and has to flee.
Yes.
Oh, in the name of Jesus, I receive that.
In the name of Jesus.
I receive that. Jesus.
Come on, I just feel it breaking in the spirit right now.
Lord.
I feel it breaking in the name of Jesus. All the frustration. Come on. Somebody's been flustered. Somebody's been frustrated. I don't know who you are, but you need to give it to Jesus right now. You've been so flustered, you don't even know how to worship God correctly.
Thank you, Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
I receive it, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I receive it. I receive it.
Jesus, right now. Jesus. Lord God Almighty. Jesus. Oh. It's breaking right now. I feel it. I sense it. It's breaking right now in the name of Jesus. The Lord's saying He's replacing your mourning for joy.
Woo! Thank you, Lord. Receiving it, Lord. Receive it.
You're restoring your frustration with happiness.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. I shut that out of your shape and the
soul.
Jesus. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, just receive it right now. Receive it right now in the name of Jesus. Receive it in the name of Jesus. Just lift your hand and say, Lord, I receive. I receive your strength.
All of us need you.
I receive your healing. I receive your comfort. I receive your joy. Lord, I receive. Jesus, right now, Father.